Normally, you'll have Jason Roy batting beautifully at the top, taking the onus right at the top. That didn't happen last game. We saw Josh Butler get 100. We saw Joe Root get 100. But to me, what's most important is that when someone does get 100, it's important that one of them stays till the end, one of them goes on to win the game, which didn't happen for England. The larger issue was I just think that the runs that were given were one too many. If England can kind of make sure that doesn't happen, I think they'll be okay. But again, England, a powerful side, a good side, they've had a hiccup. I think they'll just come back stronger from that. Very surprised with the way Jofra Archer struggled the last game against Pakistan. I thought after seeing Pakistan bat so poorly against West Indies in the first game with a lot of bouncers, when we saw the West Indies bowlers peppering the Pakistanis with so many bouncers with pace and bounce, I thought Jofra Archer will be a handful. But I just thought he bowled poorly, he bowled the wrong lines, he bowled the wrong length. He kept peppering it in short, but there was too much width given, and that's exactly why he was expensive. And I get a feeling that he would have learned from that. He's had a poor game, but I'll tell you what, he is an X-factor. He's a serious bowler. That's exactly the reason why England brought him into the side in the last minute. One poor game, but I'll tell you what, if the wicket that we've seen at the Sophia Gardens will be the way it is, or will be the way they were in the last two games, Sri Lanka, New Zealand, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, both the games played on absolute green tops. There was so much an offer for the fast bowlers. And if the wicket is similar to those matches, I'll tell you, Jofra Archer will be more than a handful. He will have these guys hopping everywhere. Bangladesh not used to pace and bounce, and if there is some pace, Jofra Archer, I'll tell you what, watch out for him. Shakibul Hasan has been a big plus for Bangladesh, has batted beautifully, has bowled beautifully, has made sure that he's got runs in the middle, has made sure that he put on a good partnership with Mushfiqur Rahim in the first game against South Africa. Even the next game saw him bat well. Just like the way that he goes about doing his business, like the way he goes about batting, takes a bit of time to start with and then exactly knows which bowlers to target, which areas to target. And that's all pure experience. We've seen him do it so many times in the past for Bangladesh, and we've seen that again in this World Cup. That's exactly the reason why he's probably the top all-round in the world right now. I'm liking the way Shakib is bowling. I'm liking the very fact that he's bowling slower in the air, looking to use the drift, looking to make the batsman wait for the ball. And that's exactly the reason why he's been successful in this tournament.